Hope everybody, all you can see my screen.
Yes.
Okay, great. So now here in my application, I'm going to start working with. Okay, so today we have a working with CSS. What topic we're talking about? CSS today. Okay. So CSS and little bit about a bootstrap. I will tell you both so they will, you will get the clarity of both, how they are basically utilizing it in the application. Well, that was an HTML folder. I would like to create one more folder here. Another CSS demo, I'm going to create a new file name called. And as usual, same. And under the CSS demo, we would like to create one more file here. And in fact, here itself, we can start. See, what is the CSS? As you know it very well, CSS is known for what? Everybody, cascading style sheet. It is a W3C recommendation. It is designed for styling your contents. What it is designed for? Everybody, styling your content. So whenever you would like to style, you always style with using what? CSS. And because I want to keep my site consistent across all pages, so I would like to stick thought with the CSS. Now let's get started with the CSS and see how it can be more beneficial for us. Well, here in our HTML, okay, so we can basically go back and create some tags here, like in say H1 tag. Okay, so we can say welcome to heading one. And after this H1, we would like to start working with this called paragraph tag. You can say this is para. So we have got two different type of tags that are available, H1 and P. Okay, now if I want to utilize those in my code in a proper way, so what I would like to do here in my head itself, we would like to start working with my CSS. So if you want to start with the CSS, you always start with what? With the style tag. And this is style tag. There's one option which is always available in CSS called selectors. See, CSS apply its styles on where? On your target elements. So your target elements can be selected in many different ways. Again, I'm repeating my word. CSS, we are talking about called what? Everybody. CSS selectors. So CSS comes with what? Everybody. Different type of selectors are available. Okay. So what those type of selectors are, let me try to offer you. First, we talk about CSS selectors. Now I tell you about what those types are. We have a first called element selector. Next, we talk about called ID selector. Next, we talk about called class selector. Next, we talk about called universal selector. And last, which is known as called what? Group selector. Are you clear? Everyone. So these my type of what? Selectors are available with your CSS. Are you clear, everyone? Everyone.
Yes,
so element selector means what? You select a specific element like H1, paragraph tag. ID selector means on this particular element, you're selecting the ID class. Is the class universal group? We'll be talking about one by one. So we are talking about element selector first. So in my element selector, whichever element you want to target for. So you put this element name H1 and here you put the conditions here, like what type of color you want. So suppose if I say like a color, okay, and I say blue. So wherever the H1 is found, the color will turns to blue. Let's take a look. Do you see this now? It is identify its element and change the color to what? To the blue. Likewise, I will go to where? Everyone, to my paragraph. So here I'll be talking about what? A color. Okay, so I can say tomato, and we can also use what? Text align selector. So that means I'll be having this specific element, will be having this type of selector conditions are available. Now if I go, you can see now dedicated selectors are given. Can you please try and check if it is working fine for all of you? Yes, everybody, it's all done. Please confirm in the chat if it is working fine for all. Friends, please help me with your update if the code is working fine. So that's the one type of selector which is available. Like we're talking about like the element selector. Second type of selectors which we're talking about here, that is called ID selector. Now imagine this H1. Okay, so if I add one more content of H1 here, like I'm saying, this is the heading 2. Okay, so when I go back to my browser, it automatically turns second headings also blue. What in case if I want to make sure that the second heading must have a different color? So what we can do here, come on everyone, what we can do here, in such cases we can provide what everybody, ID. So if I just provide an ID here by saying ID equal to, I can say demo. Okay, I can give the name called H demo. Okay, so this ID, rather than giving this what H1, we can give the name called what hash H demo. That means only those particular IDs. Okay, element those having what H demo would be applicable. Now I can see it is only applicable to this. Everyone, are you all clear? Please confirm, are you all clear? Everybody, please confirm. Hari, Hari Krishna, Nupur, Raja, Rohit, Sonita, Sunia, Vinisha, Jayesh, please help me with your confirmation if it is working fine for all of you in a chat, please. So everybody, what would happen now? If you really want to avoid that, what you can do is you can use this option like in what? Everybody, H1 colon ID demo. What exactly the advantage with this? That means if anyone, whosoever was using your ID, so if you say H1 space ID name, that means this selector will be applicable only to those which belongs to this ID, which belongs to H1. It means not anybody can go back and utilize this. Now I can see both are getting into what? The same. When I say H1 space what? Everybody. HD demo, color we are saying equal to what? Blue. That means it is only applicable to what? The one who is having this statement. Are we clear, everybody? So that's a benefit which you utilize into your code. So here you don't, because you don't see there's a dot options available here. Okay, so this will be always, this options will be available to you. Okay, that is called ID selector. The third option, what we're using it, that is known as called class selector. So that means if anyone is having the same class name, that means if you see here, I'm saying T ID equal to what? HD demo. So it is not going to be utilizing it here. Okay. So it will be used with the same combination, whatever we're using it now here. So if I just say P and if I say class equal to, I can say PC. So here you can also use what? Okay, so you can give the name for what? Dot PC. Okay, so you need to remember about, there would be one option where this condition will be applicable. So you can say P.PC here. Okay, that means a paragraph which contains this, it will be available to them. Clear? So that is called class selector. So please make sure that your code is working fine and do let me know your answers in the chat, please. Please update me if it is working fine for all. And with Heidi, you always use what? Hash. So, sorry, not here. Above, when you want to define it. If you want to basically select multiple things together, so that option you're also having it. Okay, so if you want to select multiple elements together, that option you're also having it. Multiple elements like in what? If you want to give the common combinations to all, that is also possible. Like suppose you're having one property called a div. Okay, and within this you have a call div one. You also have a call what? Span to talk about span one. So you can basically provide a common tool like you talk about div space span and you can say color, okay, colon blue violet. So here you can see now The color will also be changed according to the use cases. Or if you want to use background color, we can change it accordingly. Okay, so multiple selectors can be also used together, but you should always use comma between. You see now the background colors are changing. So if you only want to change the color, you can just took what the color and see only the colors are changing. So please make sure that your all understandings are clear and let me know once you're ready, please. Please confirm if it is all working, friends. I'm waiting for all of you. So your ID selectors and other type of selectors are working. I remember one thing, like just like your styles document, whichever we have created, you can also put this styles under where under your external locations too. External locations like in what? Here itself, I can create another file here called styles.css, and I will just cut down all. Okay, and I put it under where styles.css here. Okay, and in my index.html file, we can make this styles possible here, but for this I will remove this and I use line call what? Are we clear? Link rel equal to style and value equal to what? Styles.css. And now if I go back, you see it still it is working. So this is called external style sheet. Unlike internal style sheet, you can also have external style sheet. Just check and confirm if it is working for all of you. Friends, please confirm if it is working fine for all. Okay, so now you can see that different type of styles we have seen. They are all basically working the way they are there already. Okay, so selectors we have seen how it has been used. So now this CSS, we can also basically talk about what the tables, like you know it very well, the CSS is basically going beyond that. There's no limit how far CSS can go, but let's get started with a slowly. Okay, so CSS comes with a different type of options. Selectors we have already discussed with you how the CSS works. So CSS also comes with the backgrounds. So in case if you want to change the backgrounds or if you want to change the color, that option is also possible. So if you want to change the color, so there is an option available named called RGB. Like if you just think we are talking about what color, like in tomato. So suppose if I want to change the color to another format, okay, so we can use this color. So there's an option like in RGB. RGB stands for what, everyone? Red, green, and blue. What options we are talking about RGB, everyone?
Red, green, blue.
Yes, but along with this RGB, we also have an option called RGBA. So RGBA stands for what? Red, green, blue, and alpha. Alpha means you're talking about like you want the saturation level. Okay, like you want lighter, you want darker tone. That color you basically talk about. Let's talk about one different color. I'm just gonna give it now. So we have a call P. Okay, in this P, rather than color, we just give the name called what? Background color. So this background color, let me give the different value to this R. Suppose I give this R to 255. Okay, and the value to the green, I just give 99. And this value to blue, I just give a value called 71. And this alpha value, it starts with 1, 0. And it starts between that. So lowest value will be more faded and highest value will be more highlighted. So
I didn't get that. Should you try?
So if I just say here, 0.5 here, so you will see the color background here. Once again, you see RGBA 255. 99, 71, and 0.5. This color, we are basically giving it to you. And now, can you see this color here? Everybody, are you able to see this color here right now? So this color is now called red, green, blue. And if I just put it to what? 0.9. You see this now, it gets more darker. So if I just say 0.1, it becomes more lighter. This is this now, it is more lighter. So more value, and remember one thing, it starts from 0.1 to 1.0, like this. Okay, and same thing, which is applicable to what? To the other elements too. Suppose if I just put this color to, background color to this, rather than RGBA, we also have another color option that is called HSLA. HSLA state means hue, saturation, light, and alpha. Are we clear? Hue, saturation, light, and alpha. So hue, you can give it called what? 9. Okay. Saturation, you can give it, that is called, what I can say, 100%. Saturation would be 100%. Lightness, this value, you can change to, I can say 64%. That is a light. Okay. And alpha, it value once again start from 0 to whatever it is. So I'm giving call what? 0.5. It is also going to give you what? The same kind of result to your application. Okay, so just check that two options are available, HSLA and RGBA. And along with this, we also have a call RGB. Just check and confirm if it is working fine for all. Just let me know if it is working fine. It seems like it is working fine for all. So in a similar way, I would like to go ahead and talk about my tables, how we can basically align the tables. So you remember, like we were talking about these tables. Okay, so our table was working the way it was working earlier. So I can just copy this file of table and I can drag it to my CSS demo. Okay, and this table anyways, this table was anyways working like that. But if I want to do some more location in my code, so like if I say like all records, I want to basically put it where everybody, if you say in table, we were talking about a concept like in padding left, but this padding left 100% really won't make sense if I want to put everything into the middle. So we can use one option called rather than meaning this padding left. Okay, so what we can do, we can use this td here. And what we can use, text align center. Do you see this now? This makes more sense to us, or else if you want to put it here. So that is also possible. See this now, everything comes into the center now. Text align center. So this now, everything goes into the center only. Just check and confirm. Friends, please confirm if it is working. Text align center. Okay, so along with this text align center, you can also talk about called vertical alignment also. And you can also talk about what heights. Like you talk about this statement 3D, and you can also talk about what height. You can give the height. Suppose if I give call what 50 pixels, and here after this, we can give the name called vertical alignment, and then we can make it is called what bottom. Just I can confirm what happened with this. Yes, everybody, all done. Is it working fine for you? Vertical alignment is working. Okay, so let me try to make it something very interesting in your code. Do one thing within your application, apply with option called tr colon over. Okay, we'll just say background color colon what yellow. Just try and check what happens, everyone. So if you see this here, your option, you see this now, it is changing. Do you see this right now here? Everybody, it is changing. And that's the beauty of what? Of this statement. There's an option which is also available that is known as called, I would say, stripe tables. Okay, so how are you going to put this stripe table here? So in your code, if you want to put something striping like in behavior, you can just use this option like in tr. In fact, we already have this tr with me, but we can use this tr colon nth child. Okay, you just talk about nth child and you talk about odd or even. So you talk about what, everybody, even or odd you want to talk about. And here you just talk about call background color, whichever color you would like to give it. So I just want to say, light gray. So if you do like this, you will see now every alternate table becomes turns to what? To gray here. Just check and confirm if it is working. Yes, friends, please confirm if it is working fine for all. Okay, so it seems like for everybody this part is working fine. Okay, so guys, overall you just understand this CSS. Okay, have you got so much of depth? You never know for how far you can go, but yes, CSS also comes with some very serious effect. Because of that, you can really make some ideas more awesome and killing. Like how you can talk about, let's take a look now, everybody. So in my application, CSS, okay, will also help you to give you some of the different type of shapes and sizes, which was not possible earlier when we were talking about. Like I'm talking about rounded corners. Let's talk about some term name called rounded corners. So here I just remove it everything. And here I can define some div tag. Okay, I'm saying div ID equal to ID 1. Okay, so I copy this, paste it below, and I'm giving the name called what, ID 2. ID 3. Multiple div IDs we are talking about now. And here we can use some CSS here. Just watch it how awesome it is now. So we can use first of all hash ID 1. Okay. So we have some new features added here. First of all, we're talking about border radius. Border radius. This is a new feature added in CSS where we can talk about 15 pixels as inside from all different corners. If I say 15 pixels, so it will be taking the 50 pixels from all the corners. And here I will offer something called background. I can say pink. After that, I can say padding 20 pixels. Now I can give width. I can give 200 pixels. And I can give call height. Okay, so we have got like this. Now I can just go back and try to use for ID 2, but I can give a different color. I can say okay, for two different colors we're giving ID 1 and ID 2, and let's go ahead and see this. You can see now we have got two different type of shapes and sizes are available. But do you see this now? They have got some cut at the left hand side on both the side. Do you see this right now here, everyone? So just if I do not give any border radius here, you can see the difference. Guys, are you able to compare now? Hari, Pranaya, Nupur, Vinisha, everybody, are you able to see this now?
Yes, sir, Majid.
Okay, so that's the beauty of what? Giving what? The different type of border radius. So if you want, you can also give the border radius to two different portions. Like in the 15 pixels, I can give the call what? 50 pixels. So that both the shapes, you can see now, it has become rounded. See how beautifully they've organized. Just check and let me know if it is working. Friends, do let me know if it is ready and working. Friends, do let me know if the code is working fine. So this is known as called border radius. Okay, so there's an also option which is available in CSS. Okay, that is known as called gradient. What are we talking about, everybody? Gradients. Gradient is basically the transformation which move from one different type of color to the another type of color. Getting it, everyone? One type of color into what?
Another type of color.
Yes, exactly. So how I basically try to move this, let's take a look now. So here, suppose if I go back and create one more, there's a div ID 3. And here, if I just go back and I say hash ID 3, okay, and I give everything, whichever I'm having it now, I'm giving this like an, okay, everything I'm giving it just like that. Background color, I'm removing it. Instead, I'm providing this value like in what? Background image. And this background image I'm giving, it's called what? Everybody, linear gradient. And I want to tell from where to where. I say pink, okay, comma, green. Or I can say, okay, this color, if I want to make it in ID3, you just see how it's gonna look like. Mm-hmm. Guys, do you see this now, the color combination? Everybody, do you see this color combination here?
Yes.
Okay, so this color combination really make this difference. Now, just to make it better, this I just make height, okay, also called 200 pixels. So we're giving call border radius. We are just removing it, really not needed right now. And this details which you're giving it. So padding is also not needed. So height, width. Okay, so let me do one thing. Let's talk about background color. Okay, height we're giving it, width we are removing it now. Now do you see the colorway? Everybody, do you see this, how the colors are basically taking? By default, colors start from top to bottom. Is it looking beautiful, everybody? Normally, you don't get such kind of colors, but here it is so beautifully. Guys, are you all clear? Everyone? But if you want, you can also start from bottom to right. Okay, so you can change this. By default, it starts from top to bottom. You can also want, you can change this by giving this value here, by giving this option called to bottom right. We're saying to bottom right. See the what we are giving it value here for. To bottom right, and I forgot to put comma here. Do you see the difference now, everybody? Bottom right inside. So it is going like this. Can you see the difference here, everyone?
Yes.
So that's where exactly you use it. See, the advantage of this is that, like, they're going to give you different shades and colors, which really make a beautiful experience. Just try and check if it is also working for all.
How many colors will be there, Amarjit? So pink, like red. Is there any possible to do that or customize the color after now?
Yeah, you can use it. See, it's not necessary pink and tomato. You can give it any color. In fact, you can give more than one colors also. Like we're giving two, you can give three colors, four colors also. It's up to you now. Like suppose you talk about this one. Okay, so let me try to put one more color here. Call. I would say
blue.
Like this. Can you see the difference now?
Yes.
See, that one is called linear gradient. You can create some awesome effects in your development.
Okay.
And you can add as many colors you want. Like
understood, yeah.
As many colors if you want, you can add it. Do you see the difference now?
Yeah, yes, much.
So the proportion can be maintained. So just, we are talking about call linear gradient. We're also talking about call what? Radial gradient also. Like you talk about index.html file. Okay, and I say ID 4. Okay, And here in my style, I just take the same. Okay, and get the difference now. So here we talk about ID 4. Okay, and background color, whatever you want to give it. So rather than giving like this linear gradient constraint, RADIAL. No, any browser will work here, Raja. It will work for any browser. Right? You can also give this color width. This is for ID 4, divide equal to ID 4. You can just apply like this. You see the difference right now here, everybody? It starts from middle, goes till up. And if you really want to see the difference, you can just change this value to what? Can you see the difference? Friends, do let me know if it is working fine for all. So friends, can we take a quick break and come back after that? Everybody, can we go and quickly take 10, 15 minutes of break?
Yeah, sure, Amarjit.
Okay, so see you after.
Sure.
Thank you. Everybody, so are we all back from the break? Please confirm. Yes, everybody. So are we all back from the break? Hey everybody, so if you all are back, then can I give you our new assignment? Everybody, please confirm. Are you all ready for the new assignment now? Okay, so now I'm just going to give you the new assignment and just understand how this assignment can be implemented. Okay, so please take a note about that. Okay, the assignment which you're looking forward for. So everybody take a look. Assignment is like that. Okay, everybody. Please everybody watch it very carefully because this assignment is very, very important. Okay. Okay, so if you remember, we have recently seen with Friends, everybody, are you clear with the requirement? Friends, please confirm. Are you clear with the requirement properly? The one which we have typed it here. And break this with four part means what? You have to use what? Everybody. Friends, please help me with your confirmation whether you are clear with the requirement. Thanks, Raja, for the confirmation. What about others? Ashish, Bhaskar, Hari, Jayesh, Nagarjun, Nupur.
Yes, Samajit.
Sonita, Sunia, Vinisha. Friends, I request you to please be interactive in a session and help us with the confirmation if you all are clear. Okay. So what I do, I just copy and paste this requirement into the code share also so that you can easily get it. So please get yourself started and continue with this assignment and let me know once you are ready, please. After it is completion, I would like to review each and everybody's assignment. Please start now and let me know.
ఈ హెచ్టిఎంఎల్ నాకేం సంబంధం స్వామి ఏం చేస్తా హెచ్టిఎంఎల్ బ్రేక్ దిస్ ఫోర్ అసైన్మెంట్ ఇచ్చినాడు
Those who are not speaking, I request you to please go on mute. Friends, I'm sure like everybody have initiated. Please confirm in the chat. Everybody, have you all initiated? Everyone, friends, please help me with the confirmation. Have you all initiated? Thanks, Jayesh, for the confirmation. Friends, others, please confirm. Okay, great. So please continue good work. Hi Roger, but I can't hear you. Your voice is not audible. What you are done? Great. So just wait for 5 more minutes. Let's wait for the others also. Okay. So Raja, can I take a look how you've implemented? Okay, so can you please tell me what you have done it here? Prasanna, I'm unable to hear you. Sorry, Raja, I'm unable to hear you. So Raja, your mic is not operational. Oh. Okay. But I want to write the CSS styles.css, okay? Fine. Okay, so can I take a look towards your CSS styles, what you've implemented? Okay, so header, you're seeing like a background color, body radius 10 pixels, padding 2 pixels. Okay, can I see your border, how it has been implemented there in your browser? I want to see the outcome. Okay, fine. Go ahead. But I can't see footer here. Oh, at the bottom. Okay. Fine. So you're using which gradient it is? Radial or radial or gradient? Linear gradient. Okay. The background image where you applied? Okay. Main body. Okay. Can I take a look to this this HTML page? Fine, so here you're using table tier. So what styles you have applied on the table? Okay, great. Okay, can I see your HTML again? Table. Fine. Good. Good job, Raja. Overall, it is really nice to see it is working fine. Great. Thank you. Sunia, what about you? Bhaskar, Hari Krishna? Jayesh? Ashish? Remember, please, last 2 more minutes left. Next, please update me the status if it is ready. Okay, meanwhile, I will request Rajat, could you please help me to share your code in a code share so that it will be available for the others for the reference purpose. Is it okay? Rajat, can you please help copying and pasting the HTML code and CSS in a code share, the link which is there? Okay, great. So friends, I request to all, for those, the task is not yet finished. So the Raja has given the reference to your code share. I request you to please take a reference and try to finish it up. So Monday when we will start our session, I would expect this would have been created or finished by everybody. Is it okay? Everyone?
Yeah. Okay, Amarjit.
Okay, so please make sure that gets finished. I'm giving you additional time so that Monday onwards, we're going to start. Good job, Vinisha. So Monday, we're going to start working with the Bootstrap. It's a very advanced topic. For that, we are expecting this task must have been completed so that we can apply Bootstrap on the top of this. Okay, so friends, that's it. We are keeping it for today then. Okay, so thank you very much for joining. Okay, so we'll see you back on Monday once again. So enjoy your weekend and a great evening to all of you.
Thank you, Marjit.
Thank you, everybody. So see you on Monday. Happy weekend.
Thank you. Thank you.